Hi, my name is Jarrett Leiker. I'm a 16-time sport karate world champion. I've been training in the martial arts for 21 years, and I'm a fourth degree black belt in jeet taekwondo, Japanese karate do, Okinawan goju-ryu, and Okinawan kabuto. I'd like to welcome you to volume 3 of my rock solid competition bow video series. Today we're going to go over some of the advanced variations, strikes, moves, and techniques that are going to help you become a world champion one day. Let's get started. In our first technique on volume 3, we're going to pick up right where we left off in volume 2 with our neck rolls. What we're going to do with these neck rolls is we're going to add what's called the turns. We have two different types of neck rolls which we're going to review today, which one is called half and the other one is called full. We're going to add the turn, which adds an excellent dynamic technique to this move. All right, so let's get started. We're going to do the half first. I'm going to use my left hand. Again, as we learned in volume 2, if you are right-handed, okay, like I am, you want to make sure that you use your opposite hand to do your neck roll. So let me demonstrate. This way you can grab and feel comfortable using your dominant hand. Okay, if you're a lefty, you do everything just the opposite. For today's purposes on the video, I'm going to be demonstrating everything with right hand dominant. So we're going to do the neck roll in review one more time. Remember, as in volume 2, we bring the bow out to the side, straight, place that hand up by the ear, and pass. And from behind view, out, and pass. So by adding the turn, what we're going to do is it's essential for timing on this move. Okay, we have to make sure we turn at the exact time. So I'm going to demonstrate it one time, and then we'll break it down. So I'll take my bow out to my side. Okay, I want to stand completely sideways here. So put my bow out. And as it comes around, I'm going to turn, grab, and stab. Okay, so one time from behind, my bow out, and stab. Now what you want to do, again, you want to make sure you're turning into the bow. Okay, the bow is coming around, and I'm going to meet it. What you want to make sure that you do is you don't grab for it. If you grab for it, it's going to hit and fly off of your hand. So you have to make sure, just let it meet your hand. So one more time, and turn. And from reverse view, again, we're going to meet the hand, around, and turn. One more time from each angle, right? A little bit slower this time. So out, around, and turn. And from behind, out, around, and turn. Again, the keys to this move are your timing and making sure you turn correctly and meet the bow. Do not grab for it. Okay, so I'll demonstrate fast one more time. And stab, stab. That's your neck roll. Half turn variation. As we move on, as from our half neck roll turn, we're going into the full neck roll turn. So let's review the neck roll turn from volume 2, so that way you have it down. Okay, remember this one, we want to grab our bow out to the side. Okay, and unlike the half turn where we're pointing, we're going to point straight out in front of us, okay, not to our side. So straight out in front. So this is my position. Again, the same science applies as I'm going to meet my bow. Do not reach for it. Okay, so I'm going to meet it as it comes around my neck. I will do it slowly and meet. And from behind, slowly and meet. Now, as we add the turn to it, it's the same thing we just learned in the half turn. Okay, you have to make sure that your timing and meeting your bow is the most important part of this. So I will demonstrate from front and from back. And from behind, out, and back. Okay, so let's take it a little bit slower. make sure you place it up. And as the bow comes around, and bring it around, as soon as it gets to here, that's when we're going to turn. All right, as soon as it gets on your opposite shoulder. So around, turn. From behind, out, and around, and turn. As you notice on both of these neck rolls, whether it's half or full, we're ending in a perfect stance and stabbing straight out. Checking your chamber position, having a good deep stance, and stabbing out. This is half the move. It's a great thing when you can execute a difficult move in your form, but hitting into a proper stance and excellent technique, that is what makes you a champion. So one more time from each side. From behind. And that is your neck roll, full turn variation. Next up on my advanced competition bow series, we're going to move into an advanced swing combination. This is a baseball bat swing variation where we're going to use one hand on our staff and use our body manipulation to make this into a very fast, clean, and dynamic sequence. Okay, so we're going to start out with a one-handed set on our bow. You want to make sure you grab about a quarter of the way up, not too low, not too high. If you grab too high, just as we've talked about in previous volumes, is you'll hit yourself as you swing through. So like if I went to go do my baseball bat swing here, I would hit my body and it would fly off. So you want to make sure you have proper gripping position, and you always want to make sure your hands are good and dry when you're grabbing with one hand on your staff. So we're going to grab one hand and set from this position here. I'm going to go on to my first combination, bring it up on my shoulder, just as we learned previously, turn our body and swing and above our head and stop. That's the first part. So from behind, so you can follow along, up, turn, swing, stop. And as you see, I stay on the balls of my feet because I want to move fast. So let me just show you that part in a little bit quicker speed. So I'll set and stop. Right underneath my arm, as you see here. One more time, from behind, and set and turn, and one, two, and I stop. I'm gonna make sure that your bow hits an even plane as well as you're swinging across, okay, on that straight line, as straight as possible. Okay, so let's go into the next part. As we've stopped here, we're gonna swing back behind us, straight out, come behind, comes up on our shoulder, and we punch. So one more time, I'm here on my trap, swing, punch. You can do this from a front stance, or you can come up on the ball of your foot, as you see here. Either ball of the foot or front stance. Okay, so from behind now, from my trap, swing, punch, either on the ball of the foot or flat. Okay, so let's take that all together slow. So starting position, out, swing, trap, turn, punch. Okay, behind, set, turn, swing, trap, turn, punch. Now we're going to finish it. The ending of this combination is very crucial that you swing the bow the correct way. If you do not, you're not going to be able to get into the final strike, and your bow will likely hit the ground. So let me demonstrate from here. At my punch, I'm going to bring my feet together and spin. Okay, they don't have to be all the way together. You just need to try to bring them tight. Okay, so one more time. One, two. So from behind, one, two, as I spin tight. So now what we're doing with the bow is we're going to be swinging it at a downward angle. Because what we're going to do is we're going to slide right into a strike. One, two. So from behind, I want to swing it here. One, two. The reason why that motion needs to come out that way is because you're swinging down and it flows right into your strike. Okay, so from a side view, you can see it goes straight down smooth. So let's take the whole thing really slow, a few times on each angle. So I set, start, and turn. One, trap, swing, punch, turn, swing, strike. Okay, everything's straight on my front stance. So one more time from this angle, set, turn, swing, trap, swing, punch, turn, swing, strike. Now a little bit faster. Set, swing, trap, swing, punch, turn, hit. And from behind, set, swing, trap, swing, punch, turn, swing, hit. So one time, full out on both angles. Now from behind. Again, your swing combo can be a very dynamic technique. Practice your timing, practice your speed, keep a hold of that bow. That's your swing combo advanced variations. Next up is one of my favorite moves, something that I've been doing in competition since I first earned my black belt, and this is called the palm spin. You may have seen this before in competition, but today we're going to go over exactly how we get this down and have proper technique on it. So remember, the first thing is that it's called a palm spin, not a finger spin. Do not allow your fingers to move the bow, which you'll see a lot. Okay? You want to make sure your hand is as flat as possible. When I teach this in my school, I tell everybody, think about like you're carrying a pizza, all right? Or you're at a restaurant waiting a table. And you're carrying the tray around. That's the exact same thing you want to think about when you're doing this move. So we're going to start out in our right hand because we're going to build momentum with this. That's what the palm spin is all about. If you just put it up on your hand, it's not really going to spin. You have to make sure you build your momentum. So I'll demonstrate from the front and then from behind. So starting in my right hand, because that's my dominant hand, I'm going to use my left hand to hold it. I want to build my momentum up on my dominant side. Okay, so taking my bow out here to the side, this is where I'm starting, and it's going to meet my hand up top. Okay, so from behind, out, and stop. As you see, I try to keep my hand as flat as possible when you're doing your vertical palm spin. You want to make sure completely flat. So again, from the front, side, and spin, and behind, side, and spin. Now, when you do your palm spin, you can also spin against the bow. What that means is you're going to spin the opposite way that the bow is rotating. I will demonstrate. Up, turn, and spin. Okay, so that was slow. One more time. Turn, and spin. See, I'm spinning slow, but what I'm doing is showing the balance of my technique with my bow resting on my hand. So one more time on each angle. One, and turn. And from behind, one, and turn. This is an excellent technique to demonstrate balance and control of your weapon, as well as an advanced manipulation with your weapon. So your tips to your palm spin, one more time, is that you keep your hand as flat as possible. Don't use your fingers, all right? And keep your body balanced. Do not let your shoulders move, because it'll move the bow up and down. Okay, so those are a few tips to help you with your palm spins for advanced competition bow steps. Moving on from our palm spin above our head, we're going to take it into a vertical palm spin straight in front of our body, just like this. The same signs apply. We want to build our momentum up with our opposite hand and keep our hand as flat as possible. So again, we just learned how to do above our head. Now we're going to take it in front of our body. So I'll demonstrate from several angles. This one isn't going to spin as many times, but it still catches the eye of the judge. Okay, so I'm out to my side, starting here, because I'm going to do a figure eight with one hand. So slowly, figure eight, and then it will meet. So one more time, figure eight, and meet. So from behind, figure eight, and meet. So let's check out the move. From behind. Important that you keep your hands straight out in front of you. Don't raise it up or drop it down as you go, because the consistency of your hand is going to determine if your bow is going to stay on there. Because if you think about this, your bow is spinning completely flat on your hand, just like this. Very impressive and very difficult. So you want to make sure, hold it out straight out in front of you. So one more time, the momentum right here is the key. If you don't spin enough and you go too slow, it's just going to drop and hit the ground. So we want to get a good momentum on our twirl and down. So from behind and down. So from another angle on the side and down. Another angle and down. And as you see, I'm trapping it right after. I'm popping it straight down so I can move on to my next move. So a combination that you could use for this. This goes for both vertical palm spin, okay, right here, or palm spin above your head. So I'll show you on the vertical. One, turn, and raise. Okay, this above the head pass, we've already learned in previous videos. So again, I would come roll, turn, down. Remember, you want to get those fingers up and set. So from behind and roll, turn, set. So now from these two angles. One, two. From side, and one, turn, two. When you practice this, make sure that you spin quick. As soon as you grab that, turn your body tight. Throw that right shoulder hard, okay? Because it's really impressive when you can spin through quick. If you just grab it and then move really slow into it, it's not going to look as clean. So one time from the front, one time from the back. From behind, that's your vertical palm spin into a combination for advanced competition bow staff. Next up is our spinning one-handed strike. This is something that's very unique and something that will definitely catch the eye of any judge or any of your fellow competitors at a tournament. So want to make sure when you do this, you spin your hips tight right here. It's all in your hips. And twist your body. Think about like learning a basic spinning back fist. This is how we're gonna learn it. I'll put the bow down. So when you were a white belt, yellow belt, you may have learned how to do a spinning back fist, where you turn and strike your opponent. So again, turning your hips up on the ball of your foot and striking your opponent. For doing the spinning one-handed strike, think about the exact same thing. All right? You can't hit it if you can't see it. So we have to get our head around and then strike our opponent. So I would turn and hit. Okay, watch my head turn first and hit. So let's do it with the bow. We're going to take it on a normal gripping position, standard grip, right up, left down. And I would take it from a strike on an angle. So I'm going to start off here like I'm striking on an angle. So I'll do the combination first and we'll break it down. Okay, so where I'm taking this off of is from right underneath my arm, and I'm placing the bow into my right hand, like so, just like this. Okay, so from this side and out. Now how we get the spinning motion is all in our hips. So if I'm on this angle here, I'm going to turn my body, bending my knees, and striking my opponent. So from reverse, I'm on my strike, and I spin, and hit. So the full combination we will move on to now. We're going to take this, striking on our corner, and then we're going to finish it up strong. Okay? One, two, three. Four, five, and turn and hit. Now we're going to come back. We're going to do our sweep, which we've learned. Strike, sweep, and hit. For those of you that need a little bit of review on the sweep, okay, remember, we don't touch our body. We bring our feet close together, and we swing it up. So from behind, remember we don't touch our body, sweep, and strike. So let's check out that whole combination again. So we're on our corner, and we strike and hit them across our body. Two, three, four, five. Now bring it around. Six, seven, eight, and hit. Okay, so from another angle, this side, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and finish. So let's see a little bit faster. So from behind, as you practice this, get your head around, turn those hips, and this will make this an excellent combination for your form. That is the one-handed strike combination for advanced kapap. Next up on advanced competition bow staff, we're going to move into a move called the shoulder neck. All right, your shoulder neck roll combines a shoulder roll and a neck roll. The essential parts to this are you want to make sure you have proper grip on your staff, as well as body movement. Your body movement when you're first learning this move is just as important as anything that you're doing with your bow during this. It's just as important as having the bow in your hand. If you don't move the right way, it makes it extremely difficult to get this down when you're first learning it. So we're going to break it down into a few steps. I'll demonstrate from the front side and then from the back so you can follow along. We'll put the bow out in front of us, okay, just like this. Now, what I have to do is I have to turn my shoulder as I come down. Okay, either side, when I do it, I like to start with my left leg lead, and I bring it up bring it behind. And this is where I build my momentum. I'll just demonstrate the shoulder roll first. Down, and we bring it under. So one more time. Shoulder. So right there, we just have a shoulder roll. So we demonstrate from this side again. Out, behind, and roll. So how we add the neck roll is really very simple once you get the science of moving your body down. So I'll demonstrate from each angle. I bring it up like a regular shoulder roll, and I turn my body. As you see, I manipulate with my shoulders. I'm not using my hands at all. So from behind, up, and turn. So once again, this can be done from a standing position as well, just from here. So up, shoulder, and turn. You want to catch with the same hand that you're rolling with. So if you're using your right, grab with your right. Behind, shoulder, and neck. When you're training this at home or in your karate school, you want to make sure that you can put out like a cone in the corner of the room. And that may be something you can do. Or draw an X on the wall. So that way you're always knowing where you're needing to be on your angles. Because I would start here on this plane and end on this plane. So I'm starting and I roll and then roll. So I'm keeping my eyes straight out in front of me all the way through. One more time, behind and roll. Okay, and from reverse view, one, two. Your shoulder neck roll is a very dynamic move and an excellent technique that you can use in your advanced competition bow staff forms. What I always recommend is that you practice this into combinations, which is something we're going to get to in our later videos. And that is your shoulder neck roll for advanced competition bow staff. Next up is our behind the head pass. This is going to combine two moves that we've already learned. One, our wrist roll or hand roll, and two, our release. So what we're going to do is we're going to take our wrist roll, which is going to be, as you remember, we have clockwise and counterclockwise. So we have clockwise in this direction and counterclockwise from reverse direction. We're going to take the counterclock wrist roll and combine it with a little release. So let me demonstrate one time from each angle and we'll break it down. So I'm going to start with my bow up in a guard position. So once again, I'm set with my grip. I bring it up so I can build my momentum. And then I'm going to roll it on my hand roll. And then I'm going to pass it behind my head. So one, two. So from behind, I set up one, two. So what I'm doing is I'm passing the bow right behind my head, just a short little pass. Okay, it's a very dynamic move and really catches the eye of all the judges, especially when you execute it quickly. So what you want to make sure you want to do when you execute this move in your form is that you have perfect timing. So if you don't, it's going to bounce off your hand. Okay, so one, two. As we learned with all of our other rolls, releases, and passes, we want to make sure that our bow meets our hand. Do not reach for it. If you're reaching for this, we're going to knock it right off of our hand. Just let it meet. It's going to be there. So a simple way to get this down. Put your bow straight out. And what you want to do is we're not going to release. We're just going to practice the pass. Up. From this angle. Up. Once your body gets used to the timing and the placement of your hand, it makes this move relatively simple. So I will demonstrate a few more times from each angle. So I'll set my guard position up, and pass. So from behind, guard position, and pass. Your behind the head pass, much like a lot of the other moves we're learning in this video, is something that you want to put into a combination, which we're going to get to in later videos. So again, that is your behind the head pass for advanced competition bow staff. Next up on competition bow staff, we're going to get into two different variations of using your leg and your bow together. We're going to do one as a release and one as a catch. So we're going to do the release first. We're going to combine several moves in which we've learned in our earlier videos. One, our behind the back pass. So again, starting behind the back pass. Two, our wrist roll. Again, our clockwise wrist roll. Okay. And then we're going to put it all together with a release, which we've already learned. So we're going to take this, I'll demonstrate the move from both angles, and we'll break it down. So bow out to the side. I'm going to come behind. Wrist roll. Turn. So once again, behind. Wrist roll. And I turn. And as I come back, I will release. So one, I stop, release and catch. So I'll demonstrate again. Okay, so from behind, what you want to make sure you do, this little stop that I'm doing with my bow over here, is because I'm building my momentum up, and then I want to stop it and grab it. So one more time, one and two. Because I'm changing direction. I'm showing speed with my bow in front. Pah! So they're looking at it, and we're gonna stop and change direction and take it right back the other way. Okay? So now from several angles so you can see it go under my leg. I'll do straight, both sides, and from behind. Okay? This will be at about an immediate pace. So when you're doing your release, timing is the key, just as we've talked about in every single drill and every single video. You want to make sure that you're grabbing at the correct time, releasing at the correct time, and raising your leg to the correct height. When you raise your leg up and you do this move, don't think about trying to kick towards the sky. You're not trying to throw a straight up snap kick, front kick. You're just raising that leg up, and I usually do it just about chin to nose height, right about there, just enough for me to release my bow. So when you do this release, you're just coming straight under. Okay, like so. One more time, and under. So from behind, and under. So again, as you practice this, make sure you practice on your timing. All right, now we're going to move on to how we get down the catch underneath the leg. Moving on from the under the leg toss or release, we're going to practice on how to do the catch. This is a much more difficult move than the toss, and this is something that takes a lot of practice because we have to use, again, our timing. So what we're going to do is we're going to combine, again, our behind the back pass that we just did, our wrist roll, and our release. So as we do this, it's important that you get your body sideways right here. If you don't, it's very difficult to execute this move. So again, all the way sideways. You can be standing straight when you come behind, but as soon as that bow goes to release out of your hand here, you have to turn. So let me demonstrate the move one time. I go behind and grab. Okay. So what I'm doing is I'm grabbing the bow as it's releasing straight up. I'm grabbing it underneath my leg. So let me just put my bow down so you can see. This is where I grab. Right as it comes up, I grab. One more time. And grab. And from behind, so you can kind of see where it goes, and grab. And grab. So let's do it a few times from each angle. So we go from behind the back pass, wrist roll, release, and catch. Now from behind. And from side angles now. And from the other side. Again, this is a move all about timing. Want to make sure that when you're releasing, you don't have any more than one rotation on your bow. You don't want to make it float, as we learned in previous videos, how to make the bow go really high. That's not our point. Our point is to show a fast move and a dynamic move. We want to catch the eye of the judge. As you release that bow, they think you're just doing a toss, and then bam, right out from underneath your leg. So it's a very dynamic move and very clean. Now I'll show you like how you can combo out of it into a neck roll. So I'm going to go straight, one, two, and then neck roll. Okay, so from another angle, so behind, catch, roll, and from front, behind, catch, roll. So that's something that you could put right into your form, that move into that combination, and it's a winning move. So that is your under the leg catch for advanced competition bow. Our final move we're going to review on our advanced competition bow staff volume 3 is what's called our horizontal toss. Now this move takes a lot of control of your staff and your body movement, okay? Because what we're going to do is we're going to release our bow right out in front of us on a horizontal plane. So what you want to do is you're going to take your bow and grab it about right below. I have this grip on the middle of mine, so that's kind of my guidance. But what you want to make sure you do is you grab it about a third of the way up on your staff. So you're going to bring it underneath, kind of like we learned on the swing combo just a little bit ago, is we're bringing it right underneath the arm, and we're going to push out. I'm going to use my thumb right here to release it. So I push straight out in front of me. One more time, and push. It's important where you grab your bow because it's going to hit underneath your arm if you grab even just an inch too high, all right? So I want to make sure I'll demonstrate how it would hit. Like this, okay, if I was grabbing too high and it would hit me, I wouldn't be able to release. So grab your staff. I like to grab in a full grip position, both hands facing up, knuckles up, just like this, or in a one hand from a swing like this. And we push out with that thumb and bring it across. So from behind, swinging across, or with just two hands to your side, we're going to push out with this thumb and your wrist straight out in front of you. So used in a combination, this could be used out of a swing combo like what we practiced earlier. So it may be something like this, where I would swing, one, two, and push. So from here, you could bring it up, swing, one, two, and push. Now this move is not a speed move. This is kind of like what we learned in our earlier videos, is how to float the bow in the air. This is something that you don't want to throw really fast, okay? Because if you do that and you flick it out quick, when it hits your hand, it's going to bounce right off. Okay, so what you want to make sure that you do is that you float that bow. Do not rush this move. When you push it out, let it float. Okay, you want to show that off. You want to let it float through the air. Okay, so I will demonstrate on several angles now one more time. So as I would bring off of a swing, out and push it back, the opposite direction. So from the front, out, push it back, opposite direction. Side, and from behind. When I catch this, you're catching straight out with single hand grab. It's important that you catch with one hand, so you're showing the switching of the hands. So one last time, I bring it across and release, straight across. Something that you can do to get out of this would maybe a flip, swing, strike. But that's some combinations that we're going to get into in our later videos. So again, that is your horizontal toss for advanced competition bow staff. Congratulations on completing volume 3 of my rock solid competition bow video series. In volume 4 and volume 5, we're going to keep stepping our game up and learning more difficult, extreme, and creative techniques that are going to continue to make your forms better and take you to the top. Congratulations again, and I'll see you in the next video.